I think that's a pretty good transition to Shane Beamer as well. It seems what he's brought off the field almost instantly in his introductory press conference, Rick. I said it at the time. I think he said things to Gamecock fans and people who attended the University of South Carolina that they didn't even know they needed to hear. And it's going to be a completely different type of culture and environment here just a year plus in. You mentioned you like what he's doing. Can you give us a little bit more about your take on what you see with Gamecock football headed into 2022?
Well, I tell you what I like what he's doing, Tim, is that he's got the players believing in what he's teaching. And I think that nowadays is a hard thing to do. You know, you see all these kids on social media. You know, back we didn't have any of this social media thing going on when I was younger. But now it's all about social media. And I think he's done a tremendous job in navigating that along with getting his players to believe in what, you know, what they're trying to accomplish over there. The one thing that they've really done a better job of, I think, is recruiting. I think their recruiting has finally given them some depth. And one of the things, I will be honest with you, let's all be honest. Without Shane Beamer's relationship with Spencer Rattler and Austin Stogner, they don't come to South Carolina. You know, I think that you have to look at that and say, wow, you know, he was able to get a kid that was a headliner for Heisman Trophy last year, you know, going into the season. So, you know, I think he's done a tremendous job with recruiting and getting depth in the coming years. I don't think you can see it really yet, but I think you're going to see it in the coming years. You know, let's say probably not as much this year, but you'll start seeing it next year and the following year. I think he's building a program. And quite honestly, I told Shane over there at spring practice one day, I said, Shane, I got to be honest with you. I said, I don't know how you did it last year. I mean, please explain it to me. I don't know how you win seven games without a quarterback. How do you do that, Tim? That's impossible almost in today's game. And he said, well, Rick, you know, we could have, you know, two or three games could have gone the other way. I said, yeah, but they didn't. That's the whole point. So, you know, it's to me, that was a tremendous coaching accomplishment. And then the way that they coached that team against North Carolina in the Belt Bowl and throw in a whole new offense, essentially, with DeCarion Joyner at quarterback. I mean, nobody had really seen that. Now, you'd seen him a little bit, you know, spot play it here and there. But, you know, that was pretty smart. It's a pretty smart move. And I don't even know if Carolina's coaches even realized, you know, going in, you know, is this going to be good or is this going to be bad? We have no idea, but this is what we got to go with, you know. And they did a great job navigating that. And so when you win seven games without a quarterback, I think you've done a pretty effective job in your first year.
So now what is a reasonable expectation for year number two?
Well, people try to pin me down on wins and losses and all that. I don't know that, you know, you can say, well, if they win eight games this year, that's a successful year. I think what you really need to look at is just look at the marked improvement of the level of play. Okay. The level of that they continue to progress at. Now, will that transform into wins and losses? You hope so. But, you know, that football is an oblong object that bounces in funny ways sometimes. And, you know, I think last year South Carolina was a beneficiary of some good bounces and some good play, you know, that they made some plays when they had to make plays. They also didn't make plays at times. But I do think that this team is very, very capable of winning eight games this year. And you know, when you look at the quarterback, Tim, I don't think we've ever had a quarterback that talented. I'm talking about skill level. I'm not talking about, you know, wins. I'm not talking about Connor Shaw, who was a great quarterback. I'm not talking about Jeff Grants, who was a great quarterback when they were here. I'm talking about the skill level that these guys perform at. And I don't know that there's ever been a quarterback at South Carolina with the skill level of Spencer Rattler. I mean, when you can't say we've ever had a guy that should be up for the Heisman Trophy, you know, this year. We just can't. And so my only concern with Spencer is I think at Oklahoma, he had a tendency at times to force the football when he didn't need to force, you know, the football. I think if South Carolina can block for him, if they can, this is a big if now, okay? If they can block, if they can get good, just very good offensive line play. They don't have to be great. They just got to be very good because Spencer can move around, okay? But they've got to give him time. It doesn't matter if you got Tom Brady back there or Spencer Rattler. You still got to have time. And if they will give him some time, you know, to throw the football, I think this team can be really, really good. I don't think they're on the level right now of Georgia. I don't think they're on the level of Texas A&M right now. You know, so I throw those two games out. I'm not saying they can't win them because we see upsets all the time in college football. But I think if you're a realist, I think you got to say, you know, those two teams are, you know, they're just better than us right now. Now, when you get to the upstate, I think South Carolina's catching Clemson. I really do. I think, you know, this team, and I've said this to other people, I think South Carolina, this is going to be a much more competitive game with Clemson this year. I'll be very, very surprised if Clemson runs away with this game against South Carolina. I think the talent level's getting better at South Carolina. And when you've got a quarterback that can play, you've got a chance. And I think that's the one thing that Spencer offers them. And I this might be the first year in a long, long time that I think South Carolina's quarterback's better than Clemson's.
I mentioned it the other day, just with the ACC prediction and Clemson, the overwhelming favorite again, but all that pressure now pointed at the spot of quarterback, and for DJ Uiagalelei to play a lot better than he did last year, and for Clemson to get back to where they used to be. And then you got Spencer Rattler in. I don't think we've ever seen the quarterback positions more nationally relevant as the state, but the combination of the Gamecock and Clemson, even though you've seen Trevor Lawrence and Deshaun Watson at the peak, with the Gamecock situation, man, it is fascinating. From what I heard from you, Rick, I heard that you really feel like Spencer Rattler will be one of the better quarterbacks in the SEC. Any concerns about his offensive coordinator and them figuring out how best to use his talents and then the weapons around him?
No, I really don't have that concern. I think that it was hard. You know, it's hard to be an offensive coordinator when you don't have a quarterback. Honestly, it's very hard. I think that, Spencer Rattler will make the offensive, scheme look a lot better than it did last year. And, you know, in surrounding him with good receivers, I think Josh Vann's an excellent receiver. I think the other kids that they brought in are good receivers. Wells kid, I think there's going to be some, you know, the Bell kid is a very, very good player. I think he's a highly rated NFL prospect next year. They've got ability over there. It's not like they don't have guys. You know, you just got Spencer Rattler. He has nobody to throw it to. That's not the case. I think they have players over there. And one of the other things that they have that I think is going to play in their favor this year is cohesiveness. I think they have they believe in Coach Beamer. They believe as a team that they can go out and compete with anybody. And I do think I think you're going to see the end of the year, you know, barring injuries and this, that, and the other, I think you're going to see South Carolina play Clemson very, very competitively this year, where we haven't seen that in the past.